real estate has been a phenomenal, made a phenomenal recovery in here. I think that's really important. And I hope for a lot of you that you were able to ride this thing out. I saw a report this morning from the California Association of Realtors that said that in the past month, the number of, the percentage of homes sold in California in March that were distressed properties, foreclosures, or short sales was 4% in San Diego County, 4%. Statewide, it's 12%. Only 4% in San Diego County. That's the lowest percentage of distressed properties sold in the month for any county in California. We have come back, folks, in with a real enthusiasm and a real vengeance in here. And it was a tough go. I mean, I think a lot more people lost sleep over the value of their home than they did the value of their 401k. But we really have come back here. And there's a lot of things happening. I spend a lot of time with realtors and I watch all the things that are going on. But I've lived in this county for about 40 years and I've learned a lot of things along the way. I always refer to San Diego County as that place that's a little bit south of Southern California. And if you you know, you take a look at the way we sit on the map, we've got the ocean on the west, we've got the international border on the south, we've got the desert on the east, and up to the north we have that wonderful, marvelous 17-mile expanse called Camp Pendleton that protects us from Orange County and the crazy. No, you know, we have thousands of Marines up there protecting us from Orange County, okay? And do we say thank you enough? Heck no. No, we don't. We don't. So we live on an island, okay? We live on an island. And the population of that island is growing all the time, every day. 40,000 people a year, 40 to 50,000 people a year. Our population goes up here in San Diego. A combination of births, but a lot of it people moving in, despite what a lot of people would like you to believe, that people are moving out of here quickly. They're not. They're not. But we're not building any new housing. You know, we need to build about 10,000 new homes a year just to manage the population growth. And we're not doing it. We're not doing it. The last 4 or 5 years, we've averaged about 3,000 building permits a year when we need 10,000. A couple of those years, we had about half the building permits that were issued were to replace homes destroyed in fires. So we're just not coming even anywhere near even close to building the supply of homes that we need. Now, what's the very first thing you learned the very first day in your very first economics class? Supply and demand, okay? If you have a limited supply and a growing demand, there's only one thing that can happen. The value of that item, whatever it may be, is going to go up. And that's where we find ourselves right now. And the other thing is, what we're not doing in San Diego County, but for that matter, we're not doing anywhere in California or very few places across the country, is we're not building any more single-family detached homes. What they're building now are things like that thing at the end of Miramar Road at Interstate 15, okay? I'm sure it's a wonderful place. I've read all about it. They've got these, you know, it's got a, you know, stores and salons and bars and stuff, and it's going to be a great place to live if that's how you want to live. But rents now in San Diego County, the average renter spends 40% of their income on rent. That's as high as it's ever been. And guess what? It's only going to go higher. It's going to go a lot higher. We are one of the top parts of communities in the country as far as percentage of income going toward rent. When at the same time, you know, you could own a home and probably not spend as much money after taxes as you are on rent. I mean, people say, well, you know, I don't want to pay property taxes. Guess what? You're a renter. You're paying property taxes. You're just paying somebody else's property taxes, okay? So it's still a very attractive time to be looking at buying a home. Now, we'd all like our first home to be on the beach at Del Mar, okay? But that's not going to happen, okay? You go through the various stages of ownership as your life changes. You know, you start out as a single person or a married couple with no kids, and then the kids show up, and that apartment just ain't cutting it anymore. So you start looking for a place where you can have a yard and all that stuff, and then that works fine. Then the kids leave, and you don't need the big house, and you cycle down and everything else. Everybody, you know, you go through those cycles. But when we went through that cycle in our house, when our two kids left, our son joined the Navy after high school, and our daughter a few years went off to college. We're sitting in this big house that we don't need anymore at all. And after a couple of years, we kind of go, you know, if we don't get out of this place, they're going to want to move back in. And so, you know, that's when we started going through that whole downscale sizing thing. And we went and we did the thing we're supposed to do, you know, get out of that big house, simplify your life, buy a nice condominium. We did that. bought that condo, beautiful condo in Encinitas, on the beach, looking out at the ocean. First night in that place, I said to my wife, we just made a tremendous mistake. We just made a tremendous mistake. Wonderful neighbors, all that was fine. It just wasn't the lifestyle that we were used to. So it turned out to be the timing financially was great. I mean, we bought at a great time. We sold at the very top of the market, and then we bought a house at the top of the market. So it kind of equalized out. But we bought a small single family detached home because that's the lifestyle we wanted. So everybody's, we're going to see a lot of stuff going on here, but the market looks really good. We're not going to have 20% years year after year, but we're going to see prices continue to move up in here on a pretty steady, consistent basis. And real estate's a great place. It's a great investment for you as a place to live and as a place to look to invest as well. I think that's a pretty decent thing to do.